What's going on, guys? The Inhuman Beatdown. I'm back with more Fate Extra. Last time, we faced off against Julius, an assassin, and managed to defeat him. With the help of Archer's noble phantasm, of course. Now it's time to look over our opponent, who was, in fact, assassin, better known as the martial artist, Shuwen. Anyways, as stated, his name is Shuwen. A super martial artist, whose noble phantasm is No Second Strike, a deadly and powerful move, which I now will display right now. So I've set up the entire thing to be able to, for him to perform his noble phantasm, and it is weird as for the fact that it doesn't show up as normal. But if he is allowed to perform his Focus G on the first turn, he will immediately follow up with his Noble Phantasm No Second Strike, which does about 90% of your total health, blocking or not. So yeah, that attack will get you fucked over real quick-like. Be sure to Exorcist Blade his first attack. Indeed, terrifying. His keyword, of course, being the second strike, isn't needed, and obfuscation, hiding. I'm just gonna call it that. No second strike. Li Shuwen's blows are almost always fatal. Whether he throws a hard blow designed to kill, or a simple feint to draw his opponent into an attack. A saying that has managed to survive the passing of years is, for Li Shuwen, a second strike is needless. It is this saying from which his noble phantasm gets its name. To be accurate, this isn't a noble phantasm in the traditional sense of the term. Rather, it is the ultimate expression of the true power possible by mastering the martial arts. Li Shuwen is considered to be one of the very few to have gained total mastery over his style, and in fact was believed to have transcended the need for physical attacks, instead defeating his opponent by engulfing them in his chi. That's pretty crazy. There's much debate as to whether Li Shuwen actually uses his chi to defeat his opponent, although the very few who have managed to survive a confrontation with him report suffering all of the effects associated with this type of attack, such as obscured senses, heightened state of paranoia, and the feeling that their nervous system was under almost unendurable strain. That's crazy. A second strike isn't needed. This was the second name given to one of the strongest practitioners of Kung Fu in Bājíquán history. Bājíquán, I don't know. Considered to be the ultimate master of Bājíquán, it is said that this person was able to take the life of his opponent with a single, gentle touch. I like to think he poked them in the forehead and they just died. And obfuscation. A skill used to completely conceal one's presence. Although this ability allows the user to become almost completely invisible, the sheer amount of magical energy required almost screams out that some form of magic is being used. Should this person's opponent be a skilled magus, presence would be noticeable in some extrasensory fashion. There is a way to achieve this state of being without the use of any kind of magical aid, using only the abilities inherent within one's own physical form. But the level of concentration required is far beyond what humans are capable of. Good thing to note, this guy isn't human, apparently. He has an obfuscation skill of line. While a common skill of all servants of the assassin class, the level to which he is able to almost completely obscure his presence goes far above the limits normally associated with this ability. Good to know, he's above an A triple plus rank. Good, Jeff. Chinese words. Le Hu Quan, an A triple plus rank. A Chinese meditative ideal, it is a belief that true mastery of martial arts comes not through training, but acceptance. As this technique is extremely difficult to understand, let alone master, it is only when achieving the rank of A that one is thought to have actually begun to learn. Those with ranks exceeding A are considered true masters of the art. Obviously, he's a master. Concealment, A plus, or just A. A technique in which one uses their chi to blend in with the whole of their surroundings, For masters of the ability, it is possible for them to truly become one with the world, and have their very form seen to become invisible. I don't know what the point of these two skills were. They were basically the same thing. Alright, now let's get some background on Li Shuwen, apparently the master of the demonic fist. Li Shuwen, who lived from 1864 to 1934. Damn, he lived a pretty long life. A Chinese martial arts master from Yanshan County. Oh god, I'm gonna butcher this one. Hebei Kongzhousao, one of the foremost practitioners of the style known as Bājíquán. He was so powerful that many remarked that with him, a second strike is needless as long as a single blow will suffice. In addition to his skills in hand-to-hand combat, he was also supremely talented in the use of the spear, so much so that he earned the name Divine Spear Li. His occasional use of this weapon sometimes causes his opponents to mistakenly classify him as a lancer. While this wouldn't normally be entirely incorrect, due to his master's desire for a stealthy servant capable of killing from the shadows, the traits more associated with the assassin's class have come to the fore. See? He does use a weapon. Julius just wanted an assassin. On a final note, since his ability to become invisible is based on his natural abilities and not of any form of magic, he is all but undetectable to the vast majority of the Magi or anyone dependent on magic. He's pretty awesome. Alright, Master of the Demonic Fist. Li Shuwen, the Master of the Demonic Fist. Demonic Fist, not Defonic. One of the few undisputed masters of martial arts, he maintains a delicate balance between the innate goodness and inherent evil found in all men. He fell victim to poison after earning the undying hatred of the countless families of those he had killed. I mean, I can't imagine why. As a servant, the balance he maintained in life has slipped slightly, but he still values rationality greatly. While he does not see much difference between good and evil, he will react with disgust and utter contempt for those who stray from rational thinking, and for those who allow what Christians call the seven deadly sins to overwhelm their lives, he brings swift and inevitable death. Although he was known as a deadly fighter throughout his life, in his later years he discovered that true power lay not in the strength of his fists, but in the strength of his convictions. He spent the remainder of his life following the path of valor, not violence. He freely acknowledges that in his current incarnation he is nothing more than a professional killer, but does so without bitterness or regret, although he uses his powers as Julius directs. Could it be that? I don't know. I don't know what they're trying to insinuate because I don't know anything about this guy, but it was good to learn that even Japan likes to include Chinese characters into its game, whatever. He was a pretty tough opponent, and no doubt this guy was a badass in real life. Being able to... I mean, come on, you've got to be a badass to earn the thing, no second strike is needed. Anyways, that's all we really have for here, so next time we'll start out the next round, and until then, I'll catch you all later. Asta. Hey guys, thanks for watching this episode of Fate Extra. If you enjoyed this, please leave it a like and share it with all of your friends. And if you want to stay up to date with all my latest content, be sure to hit the subscribe button. Now I'm heading back to the arena to go train up for the next fight. So until next time, guys, I'll catch you all later. Hasta!